Hi everyone, I got lucky to get another 170 controller. I'm gonna turn these on so hopefully they start at the same time. That was pretty close there. This is pretty cool. Both of these have been initialized. I'll just go through a few menus here in a moment. This is a newer HC11 processor. From what I understand, this was an older processor that is no longer available. So the HC11 is the newer model. This came from Huntsville. It was given to me by Clint Johns from SLTS. He was kind enough to bring that down there. So thanks to Huntsville and them. This one was from Birmingham, and Chris Golden brought it over with Utilicom. And I know Rocky had helped me get one of these. And so this is just something to be able to show students, this old 170 setup here. Truthfully, it's actually pretty cool once you know these menu structures. And I've got a few pages just to show some of the menus to go through. Right now, the controllers are just warming up. They're going through just the initial phases that are coming up through here. So you can see they're in lockstep because I turned them on at the same time. So it's kind of fun to watch that. I'll come back to that in a moment here, just letting them continue to go. I've explained in the past, you only get 6 digits to run these things, which to me is just amazing. But the manual that goes along with this, these are both running Wapiti 4 IKS, includes kitchen sink. The menus on this, let me see if I've got this one here, so that way I printed this off so that way I could show some of these. The status, I'll let this thing finish up here as it goes through 4 and 8, and then I'll show you how we'll take a look at this for... So this sheet right here, hopefully you can see this. This just tells you what the phase conditions are. I'll try to put this in the lower corner of the screen. But as I'm looking at this, I'm just going to keep an eye on it. 03 is in flashing don't walk. This is just PED movements. The next one that'll come up here is 09. That's going to be my passage time. 0C is yellow. 0D is red. Clearance, and then we'll come back to probably 1 and 5 running a 05. That's the minimum initial. So you can kind of get a good status for phase 1, phase 5, and then what's happening. And then the menu structures. I got a couple other sheets just to print out here to show this. The very, very first menu sheet that comes up is going to be the 0 plus key. So the one that I've used quite a bit, and in fact, let me just come back here just to show this part. This is the back side of this. So if I press 0 on my first press to go into that, and then 6 is the lead phases. So if I go and I hit, and I'll do this on both of these, 0, 6. So on the CAD lights, my lead phases are 1, 3, 5, and 7, 1, 3, 5, and 7. And that these have been defaulted back. So I can go ahead and return using the F key. Back here, and you can see that we're back to phase 2 and phase 6 running on 9, which is that passage time. And these things are in maximum recall. I'll show you that one also. I think I found the right menu. This is in section 3 of the manual, where if I hit C, F key, and on the back side of this, the key that I've got max recall right here. So CFB, coffee break. So I'll come on in. Let's do C, F, B. Max recall across all of these. So I've got this that this will just be set up so that these controllers keep cycling. F to get back to the main menu. And so both of them are running nearly identical on this one. Just wanted to show this new controller, the defaulting is the same D1E94E. After you do that, you can check it with D1E. And then finally to initialize, I think it's D1F1. And that'll bring it all the way back to the beginning there. In fact, I'll go ahead and I'll do that upper one just to make sure that I remember how to do this. So if you come into 06, I'm going to take out the lead phases. 1, 3, 5, 7, enter. FFF, D1E, 94E, burns the prom. You can check the status with D1E. 0 is clean, that's all good. Going back to 06 now, I don't have any lead phases on here. So if I FFF, D1F1E, it'll go through there, and now I'm back and I've reinitialized this. So if I come to 06, my lead phases are back in here, so I can do FFF and my recall should be off. So if I go to CFB, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, EFFD1E94E. I think I've got that now. So if I come back into my CFB, which is my recalls, they're all on and we're just like how things are. So if I return out of that menu, now they've drifted apart after I did that reset. So if I go ahead and I shut these off and then try to get them on at the same time here, that'll be close enough. Ooh, that upper one, huh, that held Let's see if this comes back here. Looks like they're off by just a little bit. That was odd, that 3 and 7 that came up. But I think these things are now back to the exact same thing, just being initialized like that. The menus are pretty good to go through, the manuals, but hopefully this gives you an overview. I'm just going to watch this for just a little bit longer here to see how this does. But this is something that I didn't have access to for a long time, so now all of a sudden, I guess within about a month, I've gotten two of these units. So they're pretty cool. I know this is the oldest, and I know everything I've had, I'm trying to upgrade to ATC cabinets where I can. So just it's neat to see how old technology can actually work quite well. Same thing if you're using a terminal or going into just text-based as opposed to having some newer interface. This is... it's remarkable, so I just wanted to share this video here for those who may remember these. I know I get a lot of folks who will reach out and say, oh, I used those for years. I had one comment on the other one about going through the IMSA training. So, yeah, neat controllers. Hopefully this one will live on for a long time, especially since it's only about 7 years old. I had a date on this one. It was in the 90s, I believe. I think I got that right. I'll have to hunt around again for it. But I know there's still a lot of these running out there in the field. And so you can just see the different versions. The bottom one is Safetran, upper one McCain, but 170, it doesn't really matter. You're loading software, which both of these are running Wapiti. I don't know if I can see this card right here. This one had a problem reported, unknown, no response. Problem found, nothing. Bad CPU, 2615. So just keep taking a look at these notes here. Replaced this one bench test for 72 hours, and then it passed. So, yeah, Birmingham, they're upgrading to flex controllers at 51 intersections with a McCain controller. So that's how I got one of these. The rest of them they are going to reuse. Birmingham does an absolutely amazing job keeping these things going and keeping their inventory operating. So after this one, it should come back around, and that's going to be about it. Yeah, if you have any questions or comments, please drop them below. I'd love to hear from anyone who's used these more than I have. If I got anything wrong, please correct me. This has been trying to find the only folks I know. Clint Johns told me everything that I knew from the beginning. The folks in Birmingham also. I spent an afternoon over there in 2016, so it's been a long time, and so I'm finally got to be able to put hands on these and use them. So hope you like this. Thanks.